Tu sais ce qui arrive, menteur comme toi.
What's up guys, welcome back to another video, and today we're gonna do something very special for the ECLIPSE. Today we have some rear disc conversion. If you guys didn't know, my car came with rear drums. It is the lowest trim model, so we're gonna have to change that today, and hopefully everything goes as planned. Alright guys, I'm gonna show you how I exactly do this conversion. Everyone's gonna do it differently. This is how I'm gonna do it today. These are from AGS, but you can get some from AGS, GST, and GSX. As you can see, I did a little bit of paint job here with that fluorescent orange. Rear calipers, both right and left, right? I would get the hardware as well, just in case things break. So you're gonna need two rotors, rear. They're both identical, so you could just get two of them. You can get a Rock Auto, O'Reilly's, AutoZone. And as you can see, here is the backing plate. This is the handbrake assembly. This is your adjuster screw to adjust the amount of friction or give when you're on the rotor. So this is the handbrake that goes underneath your car. Of course, I'm expecting everything to go as smooth as possible, but we'll see how it goes. So
again, guys, if you have any more questions, I'm gonna link a rear drum to disc conversion write-up. I'm gonna link it down in the description to give you an idea. So let's go ahead. I'm gonna switch to the head cam mount, so we're gonna see some POV action. So let's see how it goes. All right, guys.
Two. It was good about having no camera, kind of like pre-positioning. It's just like you have it on your head. There's the coilovers. Checking out the wheels. Looks like this one's still a good tread. There. Oh, somewhere. This one's a new tire. Alright. We're good. There we go. So we just need to release the e-brake and then you'll be able to take it off. Boom. Look at all that brake dust, man. Holy. So if you guys haven't seen a brake drum before, this is what it looks like. And let's go ahead and get these. And then that should come out. It goes spring, this little top hat, and then the pin. There's also another part here too. That's good sound. But it is off. See, run it through the threads a little bit. There you go. So consider this side done for now. Done. Again, got those four bolts off, so should be able to take off the hub now. Use the 10 flare nut again. Yeah. Alright. I'm gonna take a little break.
Oh my god. That's dirty.
Get that backing plate.
This is copper anti-seize, by the way. Expensive as fuck, but you only use a little bit anyways. I'm gonna put it on the backing plate. There we go. Yep. If you want to, you can put blue Loctite on here. That makes sure that it's not gonna come out, but you can still take it out, but you know, it's just an added strength. Inside out, perfect lug pattern by the way, and then hit the inside. Take off my glove, this is a clean side, then swap it around. Look at that. That thing looking like a brake caliper now, you know what I'm saying? This one I also put some NFCs on there. I got used to this thing on my head, by the way. I need to make sure that shit's gonna go correctly. Red's on good. And ladies and gentlemen, I think all we gotta do now is put the handbrake cable and bleed the brakes. But this is what it looks like. It's not bad though. Not sure where that rust originally came from. So. See how shiny these things look when you clean it up.
Again, it only goes in one way, so you can't really just mess this up right away.
Alright, we're turning on. Cool. I thought it was gonna be harder than that.
And then just put the four bolts back.
Anyways, guys, a little prelude action, sorry. Yeah, but we got the brakes on, we got the caliper. I'm getting ready to, I'm tightening up the caliper bracket bolts. Not too tight. We might die if we do it too tight. Straight on, give it a little whack-a-moles. Anyways, guys, yep, we got pretty much everything done, ready to go on the roller part, so I'm just going ahead and tighten up a few things, check it up, and yeah. These are now in again. Here's this side, right? Nice with the orange, and just got done with this side. Yeah, looking really clean. Bend that little metal piece there for the bracket so you can get this out. So once you take off those bolts, take off the bolts there, push the grommet, and these should be loose. If the handbrake is down, you should be able to just slide it over like this and up. That's all you need to do. Just pop it out like that. My eye!
This thing stops so good. Doing this upgrade really increases your stopping power, and like I think everybody needs like good stopping power, and I can get on it and then stop really fast, so it's pretty good. Like, we actually have a new problem now. I went to go check the why it sounds so like a tractor. So we do have a leak around the manifold to catalytic converter again. And I don't know, man. I'm gonna go ahead and get a real OEM gasket this time, because I've gone through so many, like I've gone through paper MLS, and it's still the same result. So I don't know if it's literally the gasket I use, because the OEM one's supposed to last literally forever. I mean, there's nothing wrong with the car. But if there is like any unevenness, the Remflex should have done it. It closed it up longer than I had like the paper ones, so that's surprising. Well, that concludes today's episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the little installation And if you guys don't even have an Eclipse, but if you wanted to swap from your drum brakes to disc, use this video as your guide. Let me know in the comments if you guys need anything. And yeah, see you guys next time. Peace.